The premise of active management is essentially that with enough skill, it's easy or possible to consistently outperform the market or a benchmark. 20 years ago, the SPIVA Scorecard was launched in order to test this premise, sparking a long-standing debate with strong believers on both sides and some in between. Hello, I'm Tim Edwards from S&P Dow Jones Indices, and today we are talking about the biannual S&P Indices versus Active Research Scorecards, better known as SPIVA. Joining me today is Ben Vörös from our Index Investment Strategy team for a closer look at what SPIVA is, how it has evolved, and what we've learned over the past two decades regarding how active managers stack up versus their benchmarks. Ben, it's good to see you.
It's great to be here.
So let's start with the obvious. What is SPIVA?
SPIVA, which stands for S&P Indices versus Active, and it's a series of scorecards that is published semi-annually and that compares the performance of active managers to an appropriately chosen benchmark. The primary role of these scorecards is to help inform the debate between active management and passive management. And the SPIVA scorecards do it by providing detailed information of where and over what horizon did active funds outperform or underperform an appropriately selected benchmark.
So I can see where active managers are beating their benchmarks, but where can I test this? What regions are covered by the current range of scorecards?
So over the past 20 years, we expanded the coverage universe from just one region, which is the US, and 12 categories, to currently cover 9 regions, Latin America, the United States, Canada, Europe, Middle East and North Africa, South Africa, India, Japan, and Australia. And we also cover over 100 categories across these 9 regions.
And if you sort of look across the 9 regions, and I guess the most recent data, what important points would you highlight from the research?
So there are a couple of key takeaways that is prevalent regardless of the region we drill down to. And those are, number one, the majority of active managers tend to underperform their benchmark most of the time. Second, the underperformance rate across regions and across categories tends to increase with the lengthening of the time horizon. Number three is that when we see a period of outperformance for a given category, that outperformance tends not to persist. So to be more precise, it means that if we observe outperformance for a certain time period for a category, that doesn't say anything about the future, or it doesn't improve the odds of outperformance in a subsequent future period.
Let's dig down a little bit. Could you walk through exactly how these outperformance statistics are calculated?
Yeah, of course. So the first step we do is that we take all the funds, all the actively managed funds, so excluding passive funds, for a certain category or for a certain geography. Let's go with the example of the United States just to be more specific. So we take the universe of actively managed funds in the United States. The second step is that we assign each fund into an appropriate category, which could be small caps, large caps, growth managers, value managers, and we assign an appropriate benchmark for each of these funds, which reflects the investment objective of every single actively managed funds. The next step we take is that, let's say we talk about a 5-year time horizon. We look at the universe of active funds which were available for investments at the start of that 5-year period. Thereby, we account for survivorship bias. And the third step is that we use, again, a publicly available methodology to calculate underperformance rates over various time horizons.
The 1 year, 5 years.
1 year, 5 years, 10 years. In the case of the US, even 20 years now.
You work for an index provider. SPIVA is published by an index provider. So perhaps surprisingly enough, it shows that active managers tend to underperform indices. One might say, well, of course it does. What would you say to the accusations of bias in this study?
There are actually three factors that I would highlight that we think ensures that the numbers we report on are unbiased. Number one, we are publishing these reports at a predetermined schedule and not when we please. So every 6 months, we publish the reports regardless of regardless of whether the numbers look favorable for active managers or not. Number two, and relatedly, we report and highlight instances when actually active funds outperform in a certain category over a certain time horizon. And number three, we use publicly available data with a disclosed methodology, which means that anyone who is interested can replicate our results. And actually, there are some people who do.
So 20 years of data covering now 9 regions. Does a consistent story emerge from all this data?
Yes, absolutely. So the most important takeaway is that while on the short run, you can always find a category across our range of reports where the majority of actively managed funds outperform their respective benchmark. But if we look at longer time horizons, 10 years, 20 years, what we see is that the vast majority of actively managed funds in all categories underperform their benchmark, which just tells us that passive approach to investing is far from settling for average.
Thank you, Ben, for joining us and sharing your insights. If you'd like to learn more about our SPIVA scorecards, please visit us at the link below.